happy to find out more about this next organization. Dasha Zarina is with us now. She's the founder for the Detroit Alley Cats. Great to have you with us, Dasha.
Hi, great to be here. Thank you for having me.
Don't hate me if I'm a dog person.
Oh, no.
Dogs rule, cats drool.
My cats do drool, so that is in fact correct. They drool all over me.
Tyler and I both, well, we both have rescue animals. We know how important rescue animals are. Tell us more about your organization and how you guys got started.
So we are a cat rescue organization in Southwest Detroit, and we help the homeless and displaced cats in the city of Detroit by feeding them, fixing them, building them outdoor shelters, and finding them homes for the friendly cats and kittens.
How'd you get started in this?
So I moved to Southwest Detroit about 4 years ago, and I saw all these cats outside, and my partner and I were feeding them, and we knew that some of our neighbors were also feeding them, and that's kind of a regular thing around here. People just feed the outdoor cats. And we found three kittens in our backyard, and we managed to catch two of them. And the third one ran off. So we took in these two kittens that were already kind of feral at this point, but we socialized them and we got them used to being indoors. And so these were our two kittens. And then a year later, I see the third litter mate. He's playing in the grass outside, and I go right up to him, and he's just the friendliest cat, and he just goes right up to me. And so we take him in too, and he's actually nicer than the two cats that we had indoors, and he spent his whole life outside. So these were our three cats, Fluffy, Squishy, and Mellow. They were the original Alley Cats, and they inspired Detroit Alley Cats. So a little bit after that, we started our Detroit Alley Cat Instagram, where we were just posting pictures of the cats we were feeding, and we were fixing them at that point. And so that's what we were doing. And so there was this other cat, this other friendly community cat. We called him Zorro, and he was another friendly outdoor cat who was fed by various different neighbors, and a family had actually tried taking him inside and adopting him, but he always was trying to go outside. So he just preferred living outdoors. So this is Angel. She just jumped on my lap.
She's beautiful.
She is.
Thank you. She's one of our rescues.
That's okay. We like being pet bombed.
We do.
Yeah. So he was just this friendly outdoor cat. And so we just kind of let him hang out outside. We would play with him and feed him. And then one day, it was Christmas 2019, and the family had taken him inside for Christmas and let him out after. And it was a few days after Christmas that we found him outside, and he was just barely alive, and he was... At this point, he was pretty much gone. I mean, he was just choking, and his legs were paralyzed, and we just saw him in horrible pain, just suffocating. And then he was pretty much gone. And so the way that he was suffocating was how animals suffocate from eating rat poison, and so rat poison kills small rodents pretty quickly, but when larger animals eat it, they die slowly and painfully. So what we did is we made a flyer for to pass around our neighborhood to warn people against using rat poison, and warning people that there was rat poison on the street, and that, you know, people's pets could eat it and the outdoor cats could eat it, and just warning people against using it, because even if the rat gets poisoned, the cats can eat the rats and they would die. So we passed this flyer around our neighborhood, and we actually did get a phone call from the flyer from somebody who found rat poison. And so after that, we said, okay, we want to do more for these cats because they shouldn't be outside. We saw firsthand how dangerous it is for cats outside. And so after that, we really started connecting with other rescuers and finding cats who needed homes and finding people to foster them and really trying to place these cats into homes. And then we have an adoption application on our website, and we have a screening process, so we don't just give out the cats. And then we started having a lot of people contacting us looking for cats, and sometimes we even have more people looking for cats than we have cats. So that's a good problem
to have.
Right.
Oh, yeah.
Right. So that's our story, and we really try to place every friendly cat into a home.
So we are a year into the pandemic. What's it been like for you and some of your team members to continue this work in the middle of COVID-19 and the crisis? Have you found more and more people are willing to take in animals during this time?
Well, actually, we started our adoption process right as the pandemic hit. So I think that might have been why we have so many people looking for cats, and it's, you know, been a lot easier for us to find these cats' homes. But we still continue our work. We get them fixed at the local clinic, and it's just a curbside visit, and we still do our trapping and our fixing, and it hasn't really affected our work too much, honestly. We still continue to feed them outside, and everything is through social media with us right now, and we've had pretty good luck, I guess, with that.
How are donations going?
So we've had great support whenever we have a vet bill, a big vet bill that we need covered. People are very supportive in donating to cover expenses like that. So that's been great. So we're really fortunate to have that channel for donations, and we never hesitate to take a cat to a vet at the first sign of anything wrong. So all of our cats are healthy thanks to our donors.
Dasha Zarina with us here on the Mega Cast. She's the founder for Detroit Alley Cats. If people want to learn more about your organization, where can they find that information?
So they can go on our website, DetroitAlleyCats.com, and our Instagram, Detroit Alley Cats, with a Z at the end instead of an S. And we have our information on our website and our donation links, and we sell merchandise, and we have a volunteer application, our adoption applications, and also a surrendered cat intake form.
So one of the things when you come across some of the cats out in the community when they're feral, mm-hmm. what advice would you give to someone who comes across a feral cat and they are trying to maybe trap it? Is that a good idea or no?
Yeah, so we trap with a process called TNR. It stands for trap, neuter, return. And that's where you use a special humane trap to trap the cat, and you fix it at a local clinic, and then you release it back where you found it. So that would be the main process for dealing with feral cats. We don't advise that people try to catch the cat themselves. You definitely don't want to get scratched or bitten by a feral cat. If people want any more information on TNR or how to get involved locally, they can definitely contact us on our website. We're happy to provide more information, but that is the main process of dealing with feral cats, and it's the most humane way of dealing with a feral cat population, and this would definitely be the main route to go for dealing with feral cats.
What other advice do you have to people that want to do something when they see an overpopulation of cats in their neighborhood? They want to do something, but they can't take them all in.
Right.
What advice do you give to them?
Well, you can definitely keep feeding them, And another thing you can do is you can build them shelters for when it gets cold that they can live in, and they can live pretty good lives outside in the winter. And as long as they have these shelters, they can, you know, they can live in those in the winter. And we actually have a shelter that we designed that we're releasing a manual for this month, and people can build their own shelters. And you can find online how to build these shelters out of coolers and just all kinds of stuff, and it's really easy. And so that's one thing you can do. But really, I mean, you really can just feed them and fix them, and that's the main thing.
So the spay and neutering program, how vital is that to help try to curb the overpopulation of pets?
So that's really important. I mean, like I said, it is the most humane way of controlling the population, and pregnancies are also really hard on cats. So it does make their lives a lot healthier to live outside after they've been fixed, and it definitely you know. It helps all around. It helps reduce the population, helps make their lives healthier, and it's really the best way to go when dealing with the feral cat population.
So how many cats do you have now?
we lost count. I think we have three that are ours, and then I think five fosters right now.
Oh my goodness. Yeah, I bet you can walk through the neighborhood and name them all, though.
Yes.
Well, we so appreciate your time. Again, Dasha Zarina with us here on the MegaCast. She's the founder for Detroit Alley Cats. If you can help them, please do so. You're doing such good work there in your neighborhood. We appreciate your time.
Thank you.